Oh, so many new or the freshers might say that, okay, we have seen relationships in real world. So now you will understand some deep relationships in the database. So relationships. Inside the database, there are three types of relationships that exist. 1-to-1, and then 1-to-many, and many-to-many. Okay, thank God we don't have a complex relationship inside the database. Okay, so what are these relationships? You need to understand this relationship in a way, in a real world scenario. See guys, normalization is dead simple. The problem is DBAs make it complex, or the person who's working on it makes it complex. If you talk about normalization, consider it as a real world example. Think in a real world example. One employee at a time can work on one project. It's so simple, right? So will it be 1-to-1 or 1-to-many? So employee to project. So one employee can work on, at a time can work only on one project, correct? So it is 1-to-1 relationship. Now one employee can work only on one project. So from employee table to the project table, it is 1-to-1 relationship. But on one project, there can be multiple employees who are working, right? It's so simple. So in this case, from the project table to the employee table, it becomes 1-to-many relationships. So one project can have many employees working on it. Perfect. So I'll use this double arrow just to differentiate between 1-to-1 and 1-to-many, right? And many-to-many, what could be the best example for many-to-many? Many students can work on many projects. So in some cases, like in some institutes, they allow you to work on two projects at the same time. So it becomes many students working on many projects. So it is many-to-many relationship, right? So this relationship is nothing but these arrows. Do you see these arrows? These are all relationships. So how do you define this relationship? It's very simple. So we have employee table and we have project table, right? From employee, okay, we'll understand. See, relationship has to be understood from both the sides. I think that's the way in real world as well. It has to be understood from both the sides, right? So any relationship that you're looking, you have to look it in two directions, this way and this way also, right? So from employee, one employee can work on one project, perfect? So this is one dimension. So we are looking at one side. But when we look at from project to employee, one project can have many employees, right? So the relationship moves like this, and to define many, we use this symbol. So to read this kind of symbol, it's so simple. If you are reading it like this, that means it is 1-to-1. One employee can work on one project, right? But if you are reading it in this direction, if you are looking at the relationship in this direction, one project, this symbol defines many. Okay, one project can have many employees. So these symbols are very important when it comes to define the relationships inside the database. Now let us look at this diagram. That should make a lot more sense to you guys. Let us understand some of the arrow marks. We can see that we have locations and we have departments. So one location can, okay, let us look at in this direction, left to right. So department, one department can be in one location only, right? So if you are looking at from left to right, so one department can always be in one location, technically correct. When we are looking from right to left, one location can have many departments. You see this symbol? So if you are reading it from right to left, that means one location can have many departments. But if you are reading from left to right, one department can be technically only in one location. Let us look at job history and jobs table. Okay, guys, I mean, I might be forcing you to use some of my techniques because it's easy and simple. So once again, now we can't use left to right, but we have to use from top to bottom. So this, if you are looking from top to bottom, okay, job history. A job history will be, one job history will be assigned or can have only one type of job, right? So the job title, let's take you have a job history, someone who worked as an assistant. Now that assistant, that job can be related to only one row in this table, right? So it is one-to-one in this direction. But when you look at a job, a single job, an assistant, there are many people who might have worked as an assistant. So if you look from bottom to top, one job title, there could have been many employees who worked as an assistant, right? So there are multiple job histories for them. So in this direction from top to bottom, it is one-to-one relationship. But when you look from bottom to top, it is one-to-many relationship. The same goes with this one. You have job history. So one job history can be assigned or could have happened only in one department, right? One single job history relates to one single department. But one single department might have many job histories. There could have been a lot of people who worked in one department, right? So a relationship, you have to see both the sides. But over here, you see this one, this relationship. What do you think, guys? What type of relationship is this one between employees and departments? Right. So many employees can work in many departments and many departments can have many employees, right? So you have to see it both the ways. And guys, these are the diagrams. If you know any database architects, they only work with these kind of diagrams, right? Now, I have a question for all of you. What do you think this relationship is, the employee table? A relationship is between two, right? Two entities, two tables. But over here, the same table is related to itself in terms of many to one. If you see it in this direction, it is one to many, right? So the employee table is related to itself with one to many. Or if you look it into this direction, many to one. So why? Trust me, guys, I want you to understand this concept. The answer is already there. See, you have a manager ID, but who is the manager? Manager is an employee of the company. So the manager details will also be there in the same table. And that's the reason it is related to itself,